Hello students, today we will discuss chloroplast engineering, which is the another important technique of biotechnology. So first of all, we will discuss what chloroplast is. Like other like we know that plastids are present in plants, chloroplast is a form of plastid which is green in color, and about 1 to 900 chloroplasts are present in per plant cell, and approximately 10,000 DNA is present in cell. The genome size is 30 to 201 kb, and the variation is due to presence of inverted repeats. Why we should do this chloroplast engineering? The question is this. So far, it is an environment friendly approach. Transgene, as we can say, the unintentional gene flow is reduced from that. Chloroplast is highly polyploid, so the amount of copies produced is quite high, and it shows maternal inheritance, so it prevents pollen-mediated spread of transgenes, providing a natural form of gene containment for the next generation of biotech crops. So if we go for the history of chloroplast engineering, the first chloroplast transformation was done in 1988 by Boynton, Gilham and Chlamydomonas, and it was firstly produced in 1990 by Pal Malga and co-workers in Tobago. These are the milestones of chloroplast transformation. So this is the year-wise history for how it was done, and references are also shown there. So if we go for the molecular biology of chloroplast transformation, it is a stable transformation and depends on the integration of transforming DNA into plastid genome by homologous recombination. Like where the homologous sequences are present, there only the integration must be done. The sequence to be introduced into plastid genome must be flanked on both sides by region of homology with the chloroplast genome. Homology is must required for the transformation. Primary transplantomic even results in heteroplasmic cells, and heteroplasmy is unstable. Later it will be resumed into homoplasmy. So methodology is quite similar to other genetic engineering techniques, like we need a vector, a delivery method, and then selection. The most common delivery method which we use are gene gun, PEG mediated, agrobacterium mediated, and microinjection. This is a flow diagram of chloroplast transformation, which is the basic technique of genetic engineering. Like gene delivery is done, then selection is done, then it is regenerated, then another round of selection is done, and the shoot is then regenerated. So if we go for the transformation, we can do single gene insertion or multiple genes. This yellow part shows genes, and in the second one you can see there are three number of genes. Then a promoter, ribosome binding sites, and a terminator. Then if we the second step is the selection. We can go for antibiotic selection or no antibiotic selection. With antibiotic we have low transformation efficiency, and without antibiotic, in which we use betaine-aldehyde, the transformation efficiency is quite higher. Next one is the next step of selection is also, then as I have told you earlier, that first of all heteroplasmic diploid plant is formed, and then this heteroplasmy is resolved and it is converted into homoplasmic diploid plant. Then gene expression. The gene expression could be multiple gene expression or single gene expression. So if we go for multiple gene expressions, there are BT operon, PHB operon, MER operon, vitamin A genes, plant antibodies, etc. And if we see the single gene expression, the plant traits like insect pathogen, herbicide resistant, drought resistant, this type of gene interactions can be seen. Then we germinate the seeds, and the transgenic seeds germinated on selectable agents, 100% germination is observed, which is a quite important feature, and these are maternally transmitted. Then these are the certain advantages of chloroplast transformation, that like there is no vector sequences, hyper expression, multi-gene engineering, no position effect, etc. The applications include herbicide resistance, pathogen resistance, drought tolerance, overproduction of biopharmaceuticals, development of edible vaccines. But there are also certain challenges of chloroplast engineering, like chloroplast transformation has been accomplished in relatively few species. The complete genome sequence of chloroplast is not still known. It is species specific, and we have to form species specific vectors for that. Its transformation is a tissue culture technique, and which is a quite time consuming technique, and also a better understanding of DNA delivery, selection, regeneration, and other processes we have to look after. Thank you so much for your attention, students. Good luck.